take the lid down, and you should find yourself in the chamber of the Ultima Weapon.
Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit, and its faith is an instrument of deception. It is not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing. In Eorzea, the beast tribes often summon gods to fight in their stead. Though your comrades only rarely respond in kind. Which is strange, is it not? Are the 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well in Cartano and call them down? They will answer. So long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether. Your gods are no different from those of the beasts. Icons, everyone. Except for this, and you will see how Eorzea's fate is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters, which prompts the question, why do they cling to these false deities? What drives even men of learning, even the great Louis Schwab, to grovel at their feet? The answer? Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise! For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to raise himself through conflict. To grow rich through conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it is ever the strong who dictate the fate of the weak. Knowing this, but a single path is open to the infinite ruler, that of false worship, a path which leads to innovation and death. Only a man of power can rightly steer the course of civilization. And in this land of creeping mendacity, that one truth will prove its salvation. Come, champion of Eorzea, face me. Your defeat shall serve as proof of my readiness to rule. It is only right that I should take your realm, but none among you has the power to stop me!
We'll be right back.
strength is most impressive. Such power befits a ruler. Yet, you lack the resolve to put it to proper use. A waste. Allow me, then, hero, to do that which you will not.
Thank you. friend! Can his strength truly be so great?
It is the blessing of light that confounds you. Your foe acts under the protection of the crystal he bears.
So, this is what empowers him.
Beyond mortal limits. If you are to prevail, the Hammer of Darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the Shield of Light. And so it shall, for the Ultima Weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Speak plainly, Ascian.
The heart of Sabeek. It is the weapon's core, an enigma whose surface even the vaunted scholars of ancient Alec failed to scratch. The magic within has lain dormant for eons.
Of what magic do you speak?
A spell without parallel. Ultima. I sought the life force of the primals for no other reason but to quicken the core. For the true power of the Ultima Weapon lies within its now beating heart.
Lahavria, what have you done?
No more than was necessary for my god to be reborn.
Damn you, Ascian.
The hour is at hand. Behold but a sliver of my god's power. And from the deepest pit of the seven hells to the very pinnacle of the heavens, the world shall tremble. Unleash Ultima!
Such devastation! This was not my intention!
Oh, Hydaelyn, it seems the task of keeping your champion alive has exhausted what strength you had left. Van Belzar, your enemy's shield is broken. The rest I leave to you.
We will speak later, Ascian. But first, I must deal with you. The question of who is mightier remains. Come, adventurer. Let us find the answer together. kidding me? The subjects of a weak ruler must needs look to a higher power for providence, and their dependence comes at a cost to the realm. The misguided elevate the frail, and the frail lead the people astray. Unless a man of power wrests control, the cycle will never be broken. You of all people must see the truth in this. You who have the strength to rule.
You boasted of unrivaled power. You were entrusted with the ultimate weapon, the ultimate magic. And still, you failed. So much for the glory of man. Growing imbalance afflicting the planet must be redressed. If it is permitted to worsen, the very laws of existence, both etheric and physical, will be warped beyond all recognition. Know you the root of this corruption? Hydaelyn! Like a parasite, she must be burned out if the planet is to recover. And not but the return of the one true god will ensure her complete excision. Yet, to pave the way for the Master's return, a chaotic confluence of untold proportions must needs be brought about. And that will necessitate the presence of the Primals. Needless to say, both you and your Scion accomplices cannot be suffered to interfere in this endeavor. You will not leave this place alive.
If thou wouldst pierce the shadows, Make thee a blade of light.
And so my conquest ends, Cid. In smoke and ashes.
The darkness hath fled before the unclosed brilliance of thy spirit. Yet it lingereth still, beyond the sight of men, in forgotten corners of the world. In the depths of the abyss yet resideth the Dark One, watchful ever. Till this evil be cast out, never shall the world know aught but a passing peace. Yet for the present, a gentle light shineth o'er the realm of Eorzea. With thee at its heart. From sparkling moat shall it swell to glorious sun, and all the world shall bask in its warmth. Blessings and joy be upon thee. Go forth, my child, and be as a beacon of hope for Eorzea and the lands beyond through all the days of thy life.
My lady, all Twin Adder units have fallen back to the outer perimeter.
The flames have completed their withdrawal, General.
Admiral, all hands accounted for.
He's still in there.
Sid, has there been no word?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Damnation!
He's going to make it. I know he is.
Ida is right. We must have faith.
Sid, can they not be evacuated aboard the Enterprise? That adventurer and the Scions are as the Warriors of Light reborn. We cannot abandon them to their fate. Not again.
I wholeheartedly agree, but flying into the midst of that would only add to the fireworks.
There must be something we can do.
Please, Mother Hydaelyn. Please light his way through the darkness.
Look into the light, my child. If thou would see thy companions return safe to thee, reach out to them now.
You almost got us killed that one time, remember?
Now, we both know that was your fault.
Thank the 12, we're safe.
Mind your horns there, Manbull.
Mayhap when you mind your manners.
Though the crystal that bound Thancred is no more, I doubt we can say the same of La Habrea. And even if we could, we know that he is not alone. Confounded Ascians. Their god may be unknown to us, but their zeal is unquestionable. Suffice it to say, it would be folly to assume that they no longer pose a threat. Nevertheless, for now, we must savor what peace we have won, however ephemeral. Do you see, Grandfather? Our first step towards realizing the dream for which you gave your life.
The dread night of Imperial tyranny and Ascian machination is ended. A new day now begins in Eorzea.
True to their name, the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, along with our champion, have delivered us from darkness.
Let their shared victory serve to remind us of our shared history. And let their bravery in the face of adversity inspire future generations.
Doubt not, the realm will need bravery in the days to come. Old rifts threaten to divide us within our walls, while hordes of beastmen claw at our gates. And though the Black Wolf be slain, the rest of the pack remains. Yet no foe need we fear, so long as we stand as one.
So long as the Scions stand for peace.
So long as our champion stands fast. For there exists no adversity over which we may not jointly prevail.
No longer can we turn a blind eye to the suffering of our allies.
No nation stands alone. If one should fall, so shall we all. Eorzea is our shared home. For any one of us to know peace, so too must our neighbor.
Just as we join in solidarity before you this day, so too shall our grand companies be joined henceforth to strive not only for the good of mere nations, but for the good of all the realm.
Change will not come overnight. Yet I foresee a day, not so very far from now, when the lines that divide our lands fade, and all of Eorzea is one.
It has been but 5 short years since the Battle of Cartano, 5 years since the advent of the 7th Umbral Era. No victory, however sweet, can wash away our bitter sorrows. No triumph can reclaim those we lost. Yet do not presume you honor them by dwelling on the past. It was not the past they fought for. You would repay their sacrifice by looking to the future.
A future united! As the Warriors of Light united in the Champion.
Now is the time for us to rise as one, bearing all of Eorzea on our shoulders.
5 years ago, Eorzea bore witness to the end of the Sixth Astral Era. Now, the Seventh Umbral Era draws to a close, yet we come together not to glory in its end, but to mark a new beginning.
Let it be writ that on this day, by the light of the crystal, Eorzea ushered in a new era. The Seventh Astral Era is come! And thus is ours a realm reborn! Flows the land's well of purpose. Walk free, walk free, walk free. Believe the land's alive. So
trust unto tomorrow. In one fleeting moment, from the land of life flow. Yet in one fleeting moment, for the new it doth grow. In the same fleeting moment, thou must live, die, and know.
What is it?
That roar. It can't be.
Did you hear that?
There's no time to spare.
Where is it coming from?
Dread tidings, chaos and carnage! It is an abomination! A primal! A primal has awakened!
Cast Bahamul move. One Azaz move star.
Fanza look pike he had Aldorn Zul Ukdorn.
Starve Chemov, the only cause the poor's right ball. call Azaria to form!
Thank you.